Yeah, hello. Good afternoon. Last speaker before the lunch, so pretty difficult to sustain. Thank you, Anandji, and distinguished speakers. Great opportunity to speak in front of all of you. We are talking about technology and various new things that we are seeing from the market leaders across the world. But in India, we are also looking at adapting those technologies and commercializing them into the markets. I have a stat. Currently, we are having more than 1,800 channel partners at MNRE on the official website. So these are the channel partners who are actually going to do the rooftop installations, and they are the people who are directly talking to the end clients, who is a first-time installer, who is not a developer, and whose main job is not solar power down plant. His main job is to run an industry or a college or school, something like that. So the lot of new entrepreneurs who are coming to market like us, we are in the market for more than say 3 4 years, but then there are new players coming every day. 1800 are the people who are registered with MNRE as channel partner, and there will be much more than that who are not registered with MNRE and who are not having access to the high level of education and research that we are seeing here. So we really want to commercialize and educate the people how solar has to be installed on the rooftops. We are talking about the 40% of the 100 gigawatt, the rooftop market that MNRE has envisaged for India. So I'm focusing more on the 40% rather than the 60% which has been discussed since the morning. Few basic points in the rooftop market that are required in terms of the quality of installations. Firstly, the installer has to understand the power scenario of the customer, the harmonics, the earthing, the transformer capacity. Those are the initial checks that an installer has to do before he goes to the site and does installation for the steel plant, for the aluminum industry, for various such kind of sectors who are having spike load or different types of power requirements. So we had faced issues with harmonics, and because of those harmonics, our inverters were shutting down. So I mean, we are confused what is happening. So and going deep into the picture, there were the PF was very low, the spikes were very high, the transformer was not completely having the proper ratings and everything. So we have to educate the customer that you just don't have to install the solar, you have to improve your power quality also. You have to save on the power that you're consuming. They don't know how much power they are consuming, they just pay for the electricity bills that comes every month. So we try to help them understand their power bill, where they are losing money, and how we can improve not just by installing solar but conserving their existing power requirements. We have seen that there are a lot of shadow analysis errors done in the market. Looking at the utility scale, there are expert engineers who do install the systems, but in the rooftops there's always a challenge of less space and you need more power. So people tend to have more panels in the same square feet area available in the roof, and they tend to ignore the whole shadow analysis. They will say that at least 6 months it will generate power, but what about the next 6 months or 3 months when it is going to have shadow on the other panel? So we really need to understand the shadow analysis part, the whole AutoCAD drawings and Google SketchUp that we all need to do to make a good PV array layout. We need to know the strength of the roof. People are installing solar plants on the asbestos roofs, which are 20-year-old, 25-year-old, and then they expect the solar plant to run for another 25 years, which is beyond imagination. So, looking at the performance and the whole solar system thing, but existing roofs also need to be understood. The structural engineer has to give a proper report whether it is able to take so much of load or not. So, we have to go deeper into the existing roof profile of the customer. A lot of times in these shed roofs, there are a lot of piercings, a lot of holes done on the roof without proper planning. So they do a trial and error and do the system installation directly on the roof without having a proper design. So that results in a lot of water leakages and things like that. So we have to make sure that we don't end up puncturing the roof of the customer. Also, the earthing and the lighting arresters part. Again, I'm saying all these because these are factories or schools in the middle of the cities. So these are high risk prone in terms of if a particular incident happens in one factory or a school or a residential, it can have impact in the nearby locations also. And they do not always have equipments for fire extinguishing and things like that. So we need to make sure the welding and the lighting adjusters and all those things are taken care of properly. New things that are coming in the market are the synchronization of solar with their grid, with having a DG set and also a battery backup. So we have to give a solution not just for solar, but we have to give a solution for the whole power, as in where they will get the power from, at what time. So during the daytime, if the power goes off, how will they get power with the DG, how they synchronize with solar, and with the new batteries coming in the market. And for critical loads, you cannot shut down the system, so you need to have batteries, and then battery gets to power from the solar or grid. So there are a lot of synchronization happening, and we need to plan our inverters accordingly so that in the future the customer does not have to again pay for the hybrid inverters if we can do it right now itself. So safety part, I again want to stress upon, we have to make a very deep analysis of the wind load. We have to make a very deep analysis of the railings. People don't really put railings on the side roofs, so it's quite risky. People doing O&M and cleaning on the roof, and they go on the roof without a proper access. They just somehow manage to climb on the roof. I'm talking about ground level scenario where we have seen systems installed where we can't imagine walking on the roof. So we need to have all the safety features when a person goes on the top and does these maintenance and cleaning exercises. So all in all, I want to sum up is that we have to commercialize the technologies in a way that the whole market installs them in the proper manner so that they last their lifetime, and they have a positive impact in terms of the distributed generation where power is required. So we can, as Anandji said, we have to not just target at the 100 gigawatt, we have to target at the availability of affordable power for each individual of the country. Thank you.